The 80s started with a question that divided the nation. Did a dingo take the baby?
I just yelled out, has anyone got a torch? The dingo's got my baby.
The disappearance of Azaria Chamberlain in the dead of the night saw an unprecedented response from the public and a trial by media like no other.
After each morning's parade, the questions like the pictures were the same. How was Lindy looking?
Meanwhile, we experienced one of the worst natural disasters in a century with the Ash Wednesday bushfires.
Australia too has won the America's Cup.
We won the America's Cup.
Any boss who sacks anyone for not turning up today is a bum.
And an underarm bowl ignited a rivalry with New Zealand.
That's a disappointing finish.
It was also the decade that terror came to Melbourne and rocked the Australian community to its very core.
The first explosion went off just before 1 o'clock when a car blew up outside the police headquarters.
The Russell Street bombing was a direct attack at police, resulting in the death of Constable Angela Taylor. It was the following year that the city of Melbourne was rocked again, when lone gunman, Australian Army Officer Cadet Julian Knight, opened fire on innocent civilians on Hoddle Street in the suburb of Clifton Hills.
Victoria has suffered the most appalling night of violence in its history.
We have main engine start.
Overseas, the world watched in horror.
Challenger, go and throttle up.
As the space shuttle Challenger broke apart 73 seconds into its flight, killing all seven on board.
This is not something that is planned, of course. I cannot see the shuttle itself.
There's no doubting it, the 80s had certainly seen their fair share of devastating news. Let's make it great. But our Australian spirit shone when we celebrated the bicentenary and the birth of a nation. A celebration of